Krishna is the lover of Radha. He displays many amorous pastimes in the groves of Vrindavan. He is the lover of the cowherd maidens of Vraj, the holder of the great hill named Govardhan, the beloved son of Mother Yashoda, and the delighter of the inhabitants of Vraj. He wanders in the forests along the banks of the river Yamuna. Radharani is Haripriya, very dear to Krishna. So if we approach Krishna through the mercy of Radharani, then it becomes very easy. If Radharani recommends that this devotee is very nice, then Krishna immediately accepts, however foolish I may be, because Radharani recommends it. Krishna accepts. Our business is to pray. Radharani, you are so dear to Krishna, so we offer our respectful obeisances unto you. Heard of the gopis' plans, they eagerly hurried to inform Krishna about this plan.
Let us go to Kusum Forest. We can graze our cows there and play some tricks on the cowherd girls in revenge for all the trouble they cause us.
Krishna seemed to approve, but then his smiling face slowly transformed into a scene of discomfort.
To come, you should go without me.
As soon as the boys left, Krishna cleverly disguised himself as a gardener and traveled alone to the forest of flowers in Kusumvan to meet the girls alone. In Kusum Forest, the girls had wandered apart in their flower picking, Lord Shyamasundar, being disguised in the form of a gardener, uttered a shout from the distance.
Who are you people and why are you plucking flowers from my garden?
Radharani Sari, however, had become hooked on a thorn tree and become more entangled as she tried to free herself.
Oh Krishna, how do I set myself free? For I have become hooked on this thorn tree. Oh my Lord, Holy Shaka, please come and help me.
On hearing her cries, Krishna arrived at the scene. Not recognizing her beloved, but nevertheless captivated by him, Radharani watched as he silently unhooked her sari.
Ah!
slowly stepped backwards down the path, her eyes fixed on his until finally the trees obscured each other's vision. When her friends found her, she stood motionless. Lalita and Visakha arrived at the sea and saw Radha.
Oh, Radha, where are your flowers?
I could not pick up any flowers because my sari got hooked on a thorn tree and I could not free myself.
So, thank you, Radhi. A young man freed me, but in unhooking my sari, he has hooked my heart.
Radharani rolled her eyes and suddenly fell to the ground.
Oh, Radhi, please wake up, for we have enough flowers for us all.
When Radha awoke, she could not return home.
I must thank he who feed me. Let us return to the thorn tree.
They all set out towards the tree unknowingly in pursuit of Krishna. They knew him so well as Govinda, Madhav, but when he appeared from a thorny grove in the disguise of a gardener, they were surprised.
Stop! You're all thieves. You are stealing my flowers.
The cowherd girls were taken aback. Radharani stared, somewhat confused. Her heart was pounding, while Lalita and Visakha went into combat.
This is my fault.
There's the garden. Lalita and Visakha looked sideways at each other but said nothing before introducing their mistress.
She is the queen of this forest. Therefore, these flowers belong to her.
The gardener, apparently unmoved by the mention of Sri Radhe, named, asserted that the flowers were the fruits of his own hard labour and therefore rightfully his. Consequently, a quarrel began. Radharani remained silent in bewilderment of meeting Krishna, yet not recognizing him. However, when she caught sight of the flute peeking out of his costume, Krishna's game was over. As Radharani spoke, Krishna broke into laughter as his game was up and bowed his head to Radharani. The cowherd girls then removed his disguise and the Supreme Lord assumed the mood of a humble servant. During the commotion, many flowers had fallen on the floor and Radharani observed this.
Krishna, what shall we do now with all of these flowers?
Oh, Sri Radhe, I should like to wash these flowers and decorate your hair.
Then, with Radharani's consent, Krishna gathered the flowers, intending to wash them in the Yamuna, but it was getting late.
We have no time for you to go to the Yamuna. Oh, come!
Krishna understood his beloved's mood and took his flute and fashioned a small hole in the ground which he filled with water. It is that which is now known as Kusum Sarovar. Krishna washed the flowers and carefully combed Radha's hair and served his most beloved. Every day, Radha and Krishna meet at Kusum Sarovar, where Krishna serves his beloved.
Sri Kusum Sarovar Ki. Krishna, 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 Krishna,
Krishna, Krishna, Krishna, Krishna,
Krishna. Once Lord Krishna heard from the gopis the news about Srimati Radharani and Abhimanyu's marriage with indeed the expansion and shadow of Lord Krishna himself. Jutila and Kutila are the mother and sister respectively of Abhimanyu, the so-called husband of Srimati Radharani in Krishna's pastime. Jutila and Kutila perform the service of facilitating the Bhagya Rasa, or the mellow of paramore love, in the loving pastimes of Sri Sri Radha and Krishna. So they were always trying to keep Krishna away from Srimati Radharani. They would chastise Krishna and sometimes call Krishna bad names to drive him away. Krishna couldn't sleep, stand, drink, sit or eat as he could not see Srimati Radharani for many days. All he thought about was Radharani, how to meet with her and how to continue their pastimes together. Radharani was also on Krishna's meditation only.
See Radharani again. But wait, Radharani lives in Abhimanyu's house. There is Abhimanyu's mother, Jatira. She cannot see well, but hears all very sharply. Radharani's room is upstairs. I can climb a tree and pretend to be a cuckoo bird. Radharani will look out of the window and I can climb in and see her.
Each night, Krishna climbed the tree opposite Radharani's room and pretended to be a cuckoo bird. Three nights passed, and on the fourth night, Radharani opened the window and was shocked to see Krishna on the tree. Krishna suddenly jumped into her room.
Radha, Radha, I'm so glad to see you. How are you? I've been sitting on this tree for three nights waiting for you, and finally I met you.
Sheila. She doesn't like me to come and meet with you.
Aha! I can hear that black snake Krishna in your room. Krishna, what are you doing here? I will catch you today and let the whole town know that you are still meeting Radha! Krishna, in fear, jumps out of the window but forgets his flute in Radharani's room. Jatila begins to walk around Radharani's room and checks every corner. Suddenly, she spots a flute in her room. Aha! Radha! Krishna was here! I know. Look! Look! Do you see? Here is his flute. I will go out and announce to everybody that Krishna still comes to meet you. By the potency of Yogamaya, Krishna's eternal energy, Purnamasi, happened to pass by to assist the Lord in his pastimes. He saw Jatila becoming very angry with Radha.
Why are you becoming so angry with Radha? Why are you blaming Krishna? Don't you see that there were flutes raining down from the sky last night? This is one of the flutes which has fallen here. There are flutes everywhere in the town.
Chatila was puzzled to see this and reluctantly apologized to Srimati Radharani. Krishna enjoyed this joke thoroughly, so he decided to make it a reality. That night, there was a rain of flutes everywhere in the town. This is how Krishna played his divine jokes with his devotees by expanding himself as Abhimanyu to perform his eternal lila.
Okay, we'll do one more. Let's do it then. Krishna! Krishna! One more.
Krishna! Krishna!
Krishna! Don't go. We have a long way to go, okay? We'll have Krishna later on, okay? Krishna! Krishna!
Krishna!
It's Krishna. On one occasion, Abhimanyu went to the market to buy some cows. He selected nice cows, and in the afternoon, he came back to take some coins to purchase them. Meanwhile, to perform mischievous pastimes, Krishna spread the rumour in Yavat. Krishna is coming in disguise of Abhimanyu to see Srimati Radharani. All the residents of Yavat, including Jatila and Kutila, were on high alert to beat and turn Krishna away. Jatila and Kutila stood at the gateway of the village with sticks. They were determined that Krishna was not even going to have a moment's glance upon Srimati Radharani. Abhimanyu came not expecting anything. As soon as Abhimanyu was walking towards his home, Jatila and Kutila started screaming at him.
Get out of here! We know that who you are! We know that you are Krishna!
in the world was happening. So he tried to explain.
I just came back to get some money for the cows. Why?
Abhimanyu hadn't a clue what in the world was happening, so he tried to explain.
I just came back to get some money for the cow to buy.
Now, get out! We know your tricks! We know your cunningness, Krishna! Get out of here now!
The original Abhimanyu ran away from the scene. Meanwhile, from another direction, Lord Krishna came perfectly disguised as Abhimanyu. When Vidura and Pradeep saw him, their hearts were overwhelmed with parental affection. They embraced Krishna.
Oh, Abhimanyu, we're so happy to see you. You know, Krishna just came and he was disguised as you. But we drove him out of his village. Now Radharani is waiting for you.
Lord Krishna happily accepted the welcome by Jagila and Kutila and gave a smile to Srimati Radharani.
Okay.
Yes.
Srimati Radharani again.
Yes.
So one more.
One day, Srimati Radharani and her associates were on their way to one sacrificial arena, passing through the path of the Govardhan Hill. Lord Krishna came to know about Radha and Gopis passing through Govardhan Hill and decided to collect the toll from them to attain the love of Srimati Radharani. Krishna smiled, assembled his friends, and made a makeshift toll booth from a black bench on Govardhan Hill.
Thank you.
Krishna saw Radha smiling, carrying a golden pot of ghee on her head as she walked with grace in the company of her gopi friends.
I cannot believe that this is the same proud girl Radha with her many friends. As I reflect on the identity of this person, I can only conclude that this must be the beautiful supreme goddess of love who has now appeared before me.
As Srimati Radharani and her friends heard these words, they approached Lord Krishna.
Look, Radha, this is your dear friend Krishna, who has now climbed to the summit of Govardhana. This is the same passionate Krishna who hid in the darkness and stole the butter. This is the great thief of the gopis' property.
My dear beautiful faced friends, what is this before us? Is it a fresh monsoon cloud?
Coming in elegant garments and ornaments, as the wealthiest of toll collectors, carried a flute and buffalo horn bugle and was accompanied by his cowherd boyfriend, holding sticks in the role of toll collectors, demanding toll collection from gopis and Radha. Smiling with content, the gopis stared at Krishna. They gracefully began to walk towards him. Seeing the sweet-hearted, charming gopis maddened with anger, Krishna smiled and angrily spoke the following words.
Oh, beautiful girl of Raja, you must pay the toll of each charming part of your body. Why are you ignoring me? I'm the tax collector and you must pay the tax now. My dear friends, sound the flutes and the buffalo horn bugles. Stop these girls and with my own arms I'll personally stop Radha.
Speaking many arrogant words, the cowherd boy surrounded Radha and her friends and stopped them from proceeding.
Krishna! 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 Krishna!
Demanding for the tax. Rajubilee started telling Krishna with many crooked words, that which were disguised prayers of glorification.
I know that you regularly travel in these forest pathways, carefully hiding these milk products and lucratively selling them in the black market. By good fortune, you have now fallen into my hands, and I'll now arrest you, bind you with ropes, and take you before the court. In this way, I'll punish you for your crime for not paying the tax all these years.
As restless, fickle-minded Krishna spoke in this way, he began to grab the corner of Radha's sari.
Krishna! 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 Krishna!
Srimati Radharani, gazing at him from the corners of her quickly moving eyes, angrily said to Krishna,
Stay far away. Don't touch me. You are a cruel, shameless rake, and I am a pious, pure-hearted girl, bringing this ghee to the sacrificial arena.
Oh. How come this is speaking to me like this? My dear Rata, please stand for a moment by the stool booth. Take a moment to allow my assistants to record the payment of your toll in the glistening fresh key and make your friends immediately do the same. Oh, Natumangal, come here. Truthfully record my toll payment. Radha, come here. Pay careful attention as Matumangal writes in his toll register. Pay your toll. Do not quarrel. Please carefully write as I speak. For your beauty, shyness, humbleness, scholarship, melodious singing, and host of other transcendental virtues, you must give me all your friends as toll payment.
After hearing these sweet words, Radha smiled with playful anger and spoke the following words.
I'll not travel on this path which has become polluted by the seducer of young girls. We have never seen or heard of any toll in milk products in town of Raja. This so-called toll is simply an invention of the king of bandits to cheat the gopis. My dear friend, just go and complain to the king of Raja. Do this and the black snake will be very happy to leave us in peace.
Krishna could easily understand the desire hidden deep behind Radha's heart. He gently smiled and spoke the following crooked words to Lalita and the other gopis. When the gopis heard Krishna's toll claims, they all laughed wholeheartedly.
My dear Radha, please do not uselessly quarrel in this way. Please understand how I'm instructing you for your own benefit. Just pay the toll and I'll let all of you go. If the great king hears that you refuse to pay the toll, he'll become angry and punish you severely. At that time, I'll not be responsible for your sufferings. You just pay the tax. If Krishna has invented a toll that does not actually exist, I hereby declare that he will bear the curse of his beloved Chandravari. Your intimate friend Vishakha is both intelligent and clear thinking. Please confer with her and decide what is to be done.
Collecting agent, I'm delighted by your wonderful words. I'll now bind this rascal toll collector with ropes and lead him away as my captive. If you are the master of the hills and forest of Raja, why do you not collect toll from them?
My dear girls, please hear me. I collect from the other travelers on this railroad. Every day you surreptitiously travel on this road unobserved by me, and thus I have not been able to collect any tolls from you. When the king heard of this from one of his servants, he called me into his presence and angrily rebuked me. He ordered me
quickly go with your companions and arrest these girls who refuse to pay my toll. Bind them with ropes and punish them. And also to collect the tax from you all.
Although the gopis felt very happy to hear Krishna's playful words, they pretended to have become very unhappy. Carrying their pots, they fled from Krishna, Krishna and his friends chasing them and stopping them.
If this toll is not paid to me, I'll take all these gopis to the great king as his prisoners.
In order to escape from Krishna's trap as toll collector, the gopis promised to Lord Krishna.
No. Oh, tax collector, please be merciful to us. Tomorrow we'll meet you here and pay this tax in full. For the time being, I'll become their bail.
Because the gopis promised to return to this lake on Govardhan Hill to pay the toll, this place is also known as Dhana Nirvadana. After hearing these words, Krishna set the gopis free. Gentle laughter decorated the gopis' beautiful smiling faces, and they considered that all their desires were fulfilled.
Very much for watching this drama. We have one more dance to conclude. Because the class has not been on bit delayed, so we're just gonna continue. We have one more dance to add up. Is everyone enjoying the Radhashtami drama?
Yeah.
So Radharani's pastimes are sweet pastimes, okay? So we are very much into the sweetness of the pastime. It's not killing the demons, but it's the sweetness. So the more we get into these dramas, the more we have the mood of Radha and Krishna, how Radha Krishna used to perform all the pastimes. Okay, so we're gonna do one more dance now. Srimati Radharani ki. Srimati Radharani ke! Shri Shri Radha Krishna ke! Please, please, please give a big round of applause for her. Please, one more time, loudly! Krishna, 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 So this is how Radha Krishna's pastimes are very, very powerful, very eternal, very sweet pastimes. So just, can we keep quiet for 2 minutes, please? Just 2 minutes. So there was supposed to be a class now. So we're gonna postpone the class till 7:30 now. The class will start after the Gaura Arti. Okay, so we were supposed to have a class, but obviously Dinabandhu Prabhu just arrived now, so we don't have enough time for the class. So we'll have a class at 7:30 instead now. So we're going to have some kirtan, we'll leading up to the Gaura Arti, and then we'll have Gaura Arti, and then we'll have a class, okay? So I just want to, don't go please, we want to introduce to the actors. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Where are you running away? Punishment for running away. There's a punishment. There's a punishment. You need to buy a big cake from downstairs. It's a punishment. Anybody who goes out, get the punishment of buying us a cake, okay? You're hungry. Gopas are hungry. Okay, so just want a quick introduction. Please keep quiet for just 2 minutes. It's as powerful, as important for us to glorify the devotees, as important as us. Okay, so very, very important. So let's bring the rules first, myself. Haribol! Okay, so we're gonna start with Radha Krishna. Krishna, 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 Radhe, 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 Krishna, 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 Radhe, Radhe. Amazing, amazing. So where should we start, Radha or Krishna? Oh, oh no, they swap now. Where shall I start?
Always Radha.
Always Radha. Oh,
Krishna, Krishna, Krishna.
Okay, right. We're gonna do Krishna. Oh, sorry. So Krishna, this amazing role played by Rasika Rani Mataji. Amazing. Just to let you know, she had a performance this morning at Bhaktivedanta Manor also. And all glory and all the credit goes to her mom here, Vishwaloka Mataji. Please come forward, please. In the role of Kutila also. She is one of the best of the best performers in the team, Rasika Rani Mataji. Any roles you ask her, she played Balaram for Balaram Jayanti, and then playing Krishna's role, playing the role of Prahlad Maharaj, playing the Lord in Lord Ramachandra's pastime. So every single role, she's such an intelligent input to this drama team. So please give her a big round of applause. And special big round of applause for her dance also. Very expert in dancing. Amazing. So, young, intelligent. Really, really amazing. Thank you very much, Rasika Rani Mataji, for being with us. So now we go to
Radha, 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 Radha.
Another intelligent devotee. Definitely intelligent than me. I'm not that intelligent, so. So, he's playing the role of Radhamani, Emilia Radha Mataji. Anybody? So, the girls have wonderful friends. They get along really well. They have that language, you know, that birds and some have their special language. So, they have that language. They synchronize to each other. And it's amazing coordination. They synchronize, somehow they just synchronize to each other. Radharani's dance, Krishna's dance, Krishna's dance, Radharani's dance. It's just amazing. So please give a big round of applause to Emilia Radha.
Hello!
And also the credit goes to her mom also here, playing the role of Purnamasi as well. Her name is Purnamasi Mataji. So Purnamasi Mataji played the role of Purnamasi also. Very intelligent devotee. I think she came on board for Radhastami festival a few years back. And it's really, really amazing to have this team. It's a small team, but the best team. No need to do any hard work. It's perfect. It's just perfect. It's amazing. It's very, very, we are very honored to be working under your guidance and under your wonderful performance. We are very privileged and honored. Thank you very much to both of you. And thank you to both the moms also for amazing preparations and doing so amazing intelligence. Ribo! So Rasika Rani has one more performance later on tonight, so three performances in the day. I'm joking, okay. Thank you very much again, very, very much. Please stay on the stage, we'll take a group photo also. So the next part, I would like to invite Nayani Mataji, a debut play in our drama name. Ribo! He's the daughter of His Grace Radhavandaneshwar Prabhu and Valeria Mataji. So she's the daughter. She has played an amazing role, carrying the basket, throwing the flowers, having the sweet. You heard the sweet, sweet voice in between. So that was her voice also speaking very nicely. So please give her a big round of applause. She was Vishakha. And okay, so the next part. We're gonna invite another gopi on the roll. Beautifully dressed. Amazing. So, Brinda, she's also like a professional actor also. She's doing amazing roles, playing wonderful things, coming on board and doing such an amazing thing. Remember, they have the school on the weekdays also. So imagine after school, before school, we rehearse, you know. I mean, this time, a lot of preparations have gone into it. I can't say we only had one preparation. We did so many rehearsals this time, just to make sure that we're on the track. Special offering to Srimati Radhamani. It's a very, very special offering to you. So thank you very much, Brinda Mataji. So Brinda is Brinda Maneshwari. So Srimati Radhamani, amazing, yeah? So thank you very much, Brinda Mataji. And also her mom. She's there, but she wasn't in a drama, but just at least she's helping us. To... Yeah!
Hello!
So now, I've got a, one person also. I'm sure most of you recognize, she's also in most of the dramas here. Aishwarya Mataji.
Arriba!
She's there on every single drama, playing a demonic role also. So, but she's not been killed. I haven't been killed every drama, but this time I'm not here. I'm surviving this time. But she's amazing role, Aishwarya Mataji. Please give a big round of applause. She's there for every single rehearsal, every single meeting, dressing herself and everything. She's self-sustained. We don't have to kind of get into that. She's amazing. An amazing team, so thank you all very much, and it's a really great honor and privilege to be with all of you on this special day. And then myself, okay, I'll have to say one special thanks. The voice, did you see the narration voice? So the narrator is Ruchi Mataji. I think most of you have seen her in the temple, but she's away at the moment, so she's the one who's done the narration and the sound. It's a very, very special effect. I'm sure, I mean, I haven't watched, but I'm sure the music was about this Dwarkadish. I think it was Dwarkadish, isn't it? Krishna.
Yeah.
Is that that one, isn't it? Yeah, I'm not sure. Yeah. So she put that music on, such a sweet music. And once again, I'm saying Radha Krishna's pastimes are the sweet pastimes. They're arguing, they're sweet pastimes. So we're going like up and down. So arguing, again, go back to the sweet pastime. Arguing, going back to the sweet pastimes again. So that's also, yeah, that's like you. Like you. Okay, so thank you very much. And myself, the Chaitanya Das, was very honored. I was happy to do the drama, but I like the long dramas. I don't like the short dramas. So we had four pastimes. So, but they're amazing. They have so much energy. So I would have added one more pastime if possible. But next time, stay tuned. We'll have more pastimes, more sweet pastimes of Radha and Krishna. Okay. Thank you very much. So the next festival will be Govardhan Puja. We're already planning from next week. We'll be starting the Govardhan Puja preparations for the drama. So that's our next part. So Kavi Karnapur Prabhu, most of you have seen Kavi Prabhu, the tall devotee who used to stay in the ashram. He's moved to different country now, so he's not going to be around for some time. So obviously we were managing the drama. We used to do the drama before he came. So most of you might be thinking, a couple of devotees already asked me about Kavi Prabhu. So he's moved to Trinidad now, back to Trinidad where he used to stay. He's going to be there for some time to support the community there. So yeah, so Kavi Prabhu is not here in the drama, at least for some time, for a longer time, we don't know. So that's the reason. So thank you very much, Srimati Radharani. Okay, we just take a quick group photo because there's no class. We'll just have aarti shortly. So we'll just take a group photo. But thank you all for staying. If you want to still buy a cake, you can buy a cake. But now you're happy to go. Okay, we don't need a cake. We're happy. Srimati Radharani. Okay, Shri Radhastami Mahamohotsav. Okay, Srila Prabhupada. Okay, Jai Jai Gaur Premanande. Jai Jai Shri Radhe. So perhaps if everyone, while they're taking the photos, and then also after the photos, while we're just tidying up here, if perhaps you just stay seated for now, just so that we can clear this area up and make it nice and tidy for the RTK time. So just stay where you are for now, okay?